Hello guys, my name is Willem and welcome to LRDX Cars. Today, like you can see, I'm at the Mercedes-Benz dealer here in Lommel in Belgium to check out the latest 2021 it is. It's from last year, Mercedes-Benz C-Class. But yeah, because it's been Corona and a lot of you have been waiting on your new car. I want to do a quick review about the latest C-Class. This also is the hybrid model, the estate, like you can see. Yeah, I want to talk you through the details and the differences with the last C-Class. And yeah, because normally I show more supercars and sports cars. It's always nice to show a more comfortable car and a car a lot of you will actually drive and will buy and dream of. So yeah, it's nice to share with you. And please leave a like and subscribe on the channel, because I'll be doing a lot of supercar reviews and a lot of events and cool things in the coming weeks and months. So yeah, please follow the journey. Let's get into the latest C-Class. I was saying, I want to talk about this model that was standing behind me. It's the estate version of the latest C-Class. And yeah, the most noticeable difference, I think, is of course, yeah, now everybody wants to have a hybrid model, because it's, yeah, 100% deductible here in Belgium if you're self-employed. And now on the C300e, the electric version, you can, the salesperson said you can drive in real, they say you can drive 100 kilometers, but yeah, in real practicality, you can drive about 80 or 90 kilometers with the car. Yeah, it's still quite much for your daily, day-to-day driving to your work and to your to the shop or anything. The 80 kilometers will probably be enough. And yeah, I wanna, normally I start at the outside, but yeah, now for this video, I wanna go to the inside, because I personally think the inside has changed the most. Like you can see, I have now the key in my pocket because it's a keyless entry. I'm gonna get in because yeah, there are some customers here and it's nicer to have a bit more a quiet video. Yeah, the first thing that is noticeable is of course the beautiful ambient lighting. You can choose between about 100 colors to have more, yeah, more comfortable inside, a bit more yeah, really nice to be, to sit. And yeah, you can choose the colors by your own, even here on top, on, even on the rear seats and everything. Really nice. And also the other thing that is yeah, most noticeable is of course in the latest model you had the big screen that continues. You had the media display and the sort of virtual cockpit in one big screen continuing. And I yeah, personally didn't like it that much. It was a bit too much screens in one way, and yeah, I'm not the screen guy. So yeah, now you have another bigger screen even in the middle, but I think it's a better setup to have the screen more in the middle. I'm gonna maybe start it up for you guys, that we have some, that we can have a little view here. Like I was saying, the speed information and the RPM range, and of course how much kilometers you can drive and the temperature and everything, you can read of course on this screen. And then the rest of the media display, like the navigation, the airco, seat heating, the other things you can all find here on the media display. It's now loading at the moment. So yeah, we'll talk about also the air conditioning vents that they also changed a bit. You can of course change the way they let the air out, but yeah, now you can see the shape has also changed a bit. Also the nice finish here is more of a metal structure of finish. It's a good look, I think. And then you have some buttons here underneath the screen. And yeah, I'm gonna show you a bit about this screen. See how easy it is to use. Like you see, you can connect your phone, of course, to call, to have a free call. You don't need to hold your phone. Well, maybe open up the navigation. Then you see I'm here in Lommel at the Mercedes dealership, like I told you. And yeah, it's a easy overview like you have. I think it's easy to use, where you want to go, the destination. Maybe go back to home, I'll show you some of the radio. Also easy to use, go further here. You have some media. I think it is when you have your phone connected that you can play your own songs, your apps. I think it's maybe the Apple CarPlay. If you also have your phone connected, you can do things like Waze. Other things, maybe it's also nice to show the hybrid, because this is the hybrid model. You see the battery capacity, how much kilometers you can drive, and normally it says it's about 100 kilometers that you can drive. But yeah, in real practicality, if you're really using it, it will be about 80 or 90 kilometers, like I said. So it's, yeah, still quite much. And yeah, it's nice. Some information about the car. The air conditioning. Here is the heating of the seats and everything. The airco of the seats. This is dynamic bottom. In which mode you want to drive. I think you have the sport, the comfort, and the eco drive probably. Yeah. This is also the automatic car, like you can see. So you have the engager here right behind the steering wheel. Drive is go downwards. Upward is rear. Park is push on the button. And neutral is in the middle when you are at your car watch or anything. Then another cool thing that changed is the steering wheel. It's it looks very good, I think, personally. It's a very good looking steering wheel. It's a bit more tight. The middle is a bit more smaller. But what I personally do not like is that they put always the buttons on the steering wheel. And now it's also, I think, more of a touchscreen buttons. And yeah, you will probably get used to the buttons. But yeah, I don't think it's easy to use if you're turning your steering wheel and you push some buttons, then the screen here changes. And yeah, it's probably, when you get used to it, it isn't that hard or anything. But yeah, I personally like it when they just keep some simple buttons on the steering wheel, some real physical buttons. Then also here some more buttons. Because yeah, when you're driving and you always need to, this and this and this, you need to constantly interact with the media display. Yeah, you will be less focused on the road and more on the media. So yeah, just for the air conditioning, I think, and the sound, they would have just put a button. I think the sound is even here. So yeah, it's smart of them to have some buttons that you can easily interact the car. Then you can see also the seats can automatically be moved frontward, backwards. You can also store your settings for your car, if you're sharing it maybe with your partner or your friend or anything. Then here you have a button to open the boot, open the fuel cap. Then here to open the windows, of course, and change the mirrors. And here some lights, the automatic parking. And this is for your wipers. And not too much going on. You have here some storage space, two cup holders, even a port to charge your phone, and even a place to lay your phone on that it will automatically charge. It's quite nice. And here in the center, you also have a big place to put your phone or your wallet or anything. I think it's also with some ports to charge your phone. And like you can see, this interior is finished in the beautiful black leather. Also a new full design of the seats with the headrest. And yeah, really like it. I have had a Mercedes myself, the CLA Mercedes. Quite liked it. I was really content with the Mercedes quality, and I never had any problems with the car. And yeah, I like the look of it, the interior. It's a good look, and it's a comfortable car. It's a classy car. It's a car that won't break or anything. Then I can see also I didn't say that this car has also, I think, the more upgraded sound system. And another option it has is the panoramic roof, which is always quite handy. Like you can see, you have a lot more light in the car, and also for the people that are sitting in the back, they have a lot more light. And also, you can open it up when it's hot, when the car has been standing in a parking lot and the car is 40 degrees inside. You just open up the roof and then the hot air can quickly float out. Maybe gonna talk also a bit about the engines they now offer. Like I said, the model I'm now sitting in is the C300E. So yeah, like the name says, it's an E, it's an electric version. You have a petrol engine. I think it's the 200 horsepower petrol engine. And then on top of that, I think there is a 130 horsepower electrical battery that sits between the engine and the gearbox to give more boost. And yeah, it will always, all the time, be giving some extra horsepower. Most of the time when you're pulling up, it will give the extra push, or you're towing anything or so. And of course, you can drive fully electric in it till I think 130 or 140 kilometers an hour. So yeah, still quite fast. Still, you can drive on the high road with it, with your electric car. And yeah, you can just do the daily, day-to-day driving to your work. And like I said, it's till 100 kilometers, and then the battery will be flat. But it will automatically charge, of course, also when you're when you're down shifting or you're braking, then the battery will automatically charge. Itself, which is quite handy, I think. And if you just need to load it up at your home with a regular charger or with a regular plug-in, it will be the whole night. But probably if you have a quick charger or a port that you have more capacity, it will probably charge faster. And yeah, we'll go outside now, check some of the exterior details. I really like the interior. You can see you have a lot of good view. I think it was always at the Mercedes is that you had a lot of good view outside. No blind spots, no dead spots, that you can see everything that is happening around the car, that you won't get in an accident or something. Yeah, it's a really nice, comfortable interior. I had a CLA, so it was a bit lower, the roof. Now you have a bit more space. I think I will also maybe get a seat in the rear. I think the rear is also a bit bigger. And on the latest model, the latest C-Class, it also, I think, with 3 centimeters, the car got longer. And I think most of that space will go to the rear seats, which is always nice that you have a lot of comfort on the rear. Yeah, we'll take a seat in the back that you can see that it's comfortable to sit. Then, if I take sit here on the rear, like you can see, I have space enough. I am, I think, 1.80 meters, and I have, I think, more than 10 centimeters left. So yeah, if you are 190, you still have room, and also headroom enough. That's quite nice. I think you can even sit with 3 people here on the rear. If you want, you can pull this armrest here down, that you have some comfort to put your arms on. A really nice place to sit, this Mercedes C-Class. Really good looking car, really like it. With all the cool ambient light, and like I said, it's quite nice. And now we'll go outside, so some of the new outside features. No. stand here on the outside. You can see the new beautiful grille. It's also the AMG line model, like you can see. They offer the business line, the luxury line, or this the AMG line. And with the AMG line, you have the beautiful stars in the grille. Beautiful sporty grille. Also the nice headlights. I think these are even the upgraded digital lights that will move depending your driving. It will stay focused on the road. Some small air intakes here. That one is even just closed. And then if you come here on the side of the car, we also see a new wheel design. These are also the more black colored wheels. You also have the full silver wheels. Yeah, like you can see, they are sort of closed on the upper side. I think it's also for the air drag. Yeah, so a good, nice design. Like I said, this is more with the black finish, like you have on the mirrors and also on the side of the windows, that more all the chrome is gone. Beautiful black finish to it. Also, like you can see, the privacy glazing comes with the night pack. And I think also on the underside, you have a small black lip. And yeah, more of a aggressive look on the bumper in the front. More sporty bumper. I think, is there another model here? Maybe I will show you if a car that does not have the AMG line. I think also the nice side skirt. It's a bit more sporty. Yeah, if you come here on the rear, we also see a new rear light design. You have this stripe that separates the upper and the lower part. Also, like I had on my CLA 180 pants. Now the car is gone, sadly, but yeah, maybe in the future we'll come here back to the Mercedes Gem garage where I also picked up my car to maybe get a new Mercedes in the future. And then, like you can see on the AMG line, you also have the more open visible exhausts, wheel exhausts. I think on the standard business line model and on maybe also on the comfort, you wouldn't see the exhaust. And now you have some little fins in to create a little bit of a diffuser effect. Really nice. Maybe we're gonna also open up the rear. This is the brake model. So yeah, you have a lot of space in it. Yeah, it's a really big trunk, like you can see. You can easily put two very big luggage sets in. And yeah, really take it on a vacation with the whole family. The cool thing is that you can store till the roof on the brake model. I think on the sedan it will only be this that will be the boot. So yeah, it's still nice enough, because yeah, if you want to see something through the rear window, you wouldn't always store it upwards. But yeah, like I read in some reviews, normally you have that the trunk is a bit deeper, but now they have the battery there, of course, yeah, because it's an electric car. And yeah, it takes a bit away the space in the car, but yeah, you can't have everything. They also need to store the battery somewhere. So it's, yeah, automatic. Nice, easy to use, real cool. And like I was saying, this car has the AMG line package and the night pack, which matches quite good on the gray, that you have a bit of the black and the gray together. I think you can also go for a blue outside color, more silver, more black. I think another gray color maybe even. Also the matte gray probably. And then you can choose between, like I was saying, the CLA 180. It's the basic petrol engine that produces about 180 horsepower, like the name says. Then you have the 200, that has 200 horsepower, like the name says. The 220 with the 220 horsepower. And then also the standard 300, that has 290 horsepower, only the petrol. And then you have the C300e, which has 330 horsepower, because you have the, like I said, the petrol engine and the battery. And then of course you also have the diesel variants, also from the CLA 180D till the 220D. And of course, as standard comes the car as a rear-wheel driven car. But on every engine like I was saying, the 180 till the 300, you can also, of course, choose for the 4MATIC drive. Maybe if you're living in a country that that it's snowing a lot, or you just want to take it on a ski trip or anything, it's always nice to have the four-wheel drive system, the 4MATIC system of Mercedes. Yeah, and I think that I showed most of the new details of this car. Maybe also nice to talk about is some safety features this car has. Because yeah, it's a family car and you want all the safety for your whole family. Normally from standard, I also had on my Sile 180, is that the car will automatically stop itself when it when it thinks that there is a car coming too close to it. It will do an emergency stop if it's needed. Sometimes it's already braking too early, but yeah, it's better that it brakes too early than too late. And then something really cool they also have on this latest model is that it also has a sensor in the rear, that when the car thinks that there will be an accident happening on the rear, that there somebody will be crashing in on the rear, the car will automatically hold its brakes, that you won't also go forward and cause more damage than needed, that you won't also get an accident in the front, it just is the rear. And then I think also from standard that the car, I think it was already on the last models, that it will keep in the lane when you're driving on the high roads. But something new that also came as standard on this car is it's quite nice that when you are in a traffic and it's, you need to wait long in the traffic, and it's really everybody is not driving that fast, it's a bit rush hour, then the car will drive itself till 60 kilometers an hour and keep distance of the car that's driving in front. Yeah, so it's quite nice that when you are in traffic, that you don't need to give gas and brake and gas and brake all the time. The car will drive for itself. It's quite cool. And then, like you can see here, they also have the sedan version of the new C-Class, also with some other wheels on it. Quite cool. I think this car is close, but yeah, like I was saying, the boot will be a bit smaller, but the rest of the car will probably be the same, the interior and the outside, like you can see. I prefer the more sedan look of cars. It's a bit more sporty. But yeah, if you have a family, if you are a big family, then it's nice to have more the brake version, that you have a bigger boot. And also this new C-Class they have here in the dark blue, which is quite good spec, I think. My Mercedes was also in the blue with the brown interior, and it's always nice. This car has a cream interior, and also an option you can go for. Then, like I said, you can also go for a brown interior, the more tan interior. A real good look, this car. And like you see, some new C-Classes, new S-Class here also on this inside, the fully blacked out look. Yeah, really, I'm a Mercedes fan, and yeah, cool car this one, this new C-Class. Now I want to say a very big thanks to all of you for watching. Hope you enjoyed a bit of the details of this new C-Class. And yeah, if you want me to do a review or a test drive, I wanted to say a test drive in the latest C-Class. And yeah, please leave a lot of likes and comment it in the comments that you want a full test drive of this beautiful C-Class. And yeah, please follow the journey, because next week I will be in Italy, manufacturers in Italy, in Modena and in Maranello, so I think he will probably know where I will be going next week. So yeah, please leave a like and subscribe on the channel, and see you in the next video, guys. Bye.